Hey guys, and welcome to some No Man's Sky. Lots of people have been having issues with the PC, the PC version. I've put some links in the description of how to fix all the crashes that I could find, and it works fine on my PC. The actual settings that I'm using are up on the screen here. I'm running in DSR 4K, so I'm literally using a dynamic super resolution. So it's actually downscaling 4K to 1080p. I'm running in windowed borderless because it works a lot better, this is the rest of my settings. Turning VSync off is important. I don't need anti-aliasing on because I've got the res so high and 100 FOV on both, and everything else. And make sure you put your max frames up, because otherwise you'll have issues. And we are not starting from the beginning. I recorded it from the beginning, but then I realised the game's for me, and everyone's probably seen all the start of the stuff anyway. Seen like a million other people's let's start the beginning of No Man's Sky kind of tutorials and stuff, and there's not really much to tell other than you start, you're on a planet, don't really know what's going on. It's all a bit weird. That was a thing that allows me to learn words. I'm good at words now. But yeah, No Man's Sky is just a really, really chilled out kind of casual game. It's kind of the end game of Spore that we should have had. Is the only way I can describe it. It is buggy. It is glitchy, but it's not awful, awful. And as long as you didn't want anything more other than a nice casual discovery exploration game, T for torch. I didn't even know that. T is torch. I suppose we should have known that. You can see it's a bit cold on this planet in the bottom left. But yeah, it's a really nice chilled out game. What's this? Oh. So these random alien artifacts are on some worlds. I'm going to go around and just learn all the alien languages and chill out and explore. It's going to be a game very much for me. I place my palm on the monolith and stand back when it melts in response to my touch. Molten rock drips down the stone, exposing a hollow interior. Inside I see riches that are beyond belief, ancient technologies and cargo that would aid my journey. Lava continues to drop and the edifice seems unstable, but equipment that could aid me is within arm's reach. Suddenly, a voice of an ancient tribe shakes the ground I stand on. I don't know what that says, because I don't know the language very well. I'm going to stand back, rather than steal their stuff. Oh, bless my show of respect. Thank you. I think I did good. Did I do good? Health at maximum. Thanks. Ah. So, what? There's four alien races, I believe. There's the birdie race, there's the Valkyr, who are the warrior race, Viking. That's the ones. I don't think they like sentinels either. So there's self-replicating robots that kind of police the worlds that I want to loot. And I'm very much a looter. There's one. And they're kind of not friendly, but they're not aggressive. Oh, so they get this. See, that storm is just destroying my protection. Darkin, word for high. I'm going to run back to my ship, because... Oh my god. It's annihilating my shield. And destroying my frame rate as well, apparently. It is 4K, that's probably why. But yeah, So loads of people have had so many problems with this. I haven't had many problems since I've set it up like that with off VSync and put it into window borderless mode. And I'm obviously running Windows 10. I've got a Windows 10 gaming guide as well. You can have a look at as well for extra optimization. And I am on a GTX 1080, which probably helps. You see my... Not enough fuel for the thrusters. Oh dear. So, a lot of the game is about collecting resources. In fact, it's most of the game. And then managing your inventory is also a lot of the game. It is very chillaxed. There's not huge depth to the game from what I can see at the moment, but I mean, I kind of expected that, and I'm relatively happy with that. What's this? That's just like it. So all this stuff, I've got slots in my spaceship, and I've got slots on my exosuit. My exosuit stuff I can carry on me, and I can transfer it back to my main ship by pressing X, and then switch it between me and my suit whenever I want. I need to actually be close to my ship to grab it off my ship, though. And I can also use those slots for upgrades So this is my Morty 2. This is my current gun, which I was mining lasers and all that sort of jazz on it as well. And you just go around finding technologies to start with. It can be multitudes of different upgrades. I'm currently using the pre-order ship. I haven't been playing that much, but I am now ready to do a bit more. You can craft a lot of stuff as well. Crafting's another big part of the game. But at the moment, I'm trying to make money. I'm trying to find an Atlas Pass, which I think I need to find some sort of Atlas Stone or something, someone said, before I can find that. We are going to take off. We're going to continue searching on this planet. So for me, one of the reasons I'm excited about No Man's Sky is because for Star Citizen, it's a good kind of what to do, what not to do with some of the stuff. I've gone down to 15 frames a second there. That is surprising. Is there anything I can grab here? No? Just a storm. Can use this beacon. Saves my game, those beacons, but also... No. Let's get up. Oh. Anything else on this planet? That's not a question mark over there. Let's go over there. So you can press shift here, and it makes me use like my afterburner booster. I do have another faster mode of travel, which I will use only for very long distances. I hate the way it granularly loads in like that. That needs to be sorted out. A lot of this feels very much like sloppy console ports, which is a little upsetting. What do you got? Nice. Storm has passed. So this is a little trade outpost. Sell that effigy. Anything else I can sell that I have on me? Nah, nothing great. Oh, so this treasure symbol, I think that means it's a valuable resource, like gold or something. Is in fact very much like gold or something. I don't think I need any more plutonium. Plutonium's surprisingly common. There's the gold. I think valuable materials mainly are just that. They're valuable, you can sell them. You need them for crafting some stuff, but a lot of the stuff... A lot of the stuff you can just get at trade outposts, or I will be able to get at trade outposts eventually. Okay. Save the game again. Oh! Occasionally we get those frame spikes. I found some interesting looking creatures. But a lot of the planets I've gone to are just mostly void of life. Let's get off this world. So we're just gonna boost up into the atmosphere. Could use our pulse engine, but we don't need to. So asteroids are just like everywhere in space, and you can blow them up for resources. So you nom nom nom. Convoy here. Could be doing anything, that convoy. Gonna scan the star system. Oh, abandoned building detected. Now that sounds like somewhere to go. There's a few things going on. Coming in hot. I just don't like the way it spawns this stuff in. I feel that there could be a much... And it's just taking me down to 15 frames a second. It's like it's loading in that level of detail on the ground, occasionally. Did it again there. I think there's something we're just going to have to deal with, which is really annoying. Oh. What is going on in this business? So this is like a bio-research facility thing. It's gone a bit wrong. Got a photon cannon upgrade. Health's at maximum. just interacting with this cargo. I'm sure there'll be something cool somewhere. Oh. It looked like a wound on the world, the crimson and ragged edged, like something that once lived and that was torn asunder. I should have stayed away. Had I the senses to taste the air of this planet, I imagined I would have reeked with some kind of alien fetor. But nothing could stall my curiosity. Was it dead? Where I touched it, the surface was moist and yielding. It seemed to become motile, and then crawling on a mat of slow... I don't know some of these words. Moving from me. I should have left it alone. Let's have a look at this data. I discovered something coded. Something that should have been left aiding me on my journey. Some technology. Oh! Oh! Some better hazard protection. I like that business. Fantastic. That is the sort of stuff I'm looking for. Are we not about to be full, are we? Oh, shit. I mean, I'm not really having any issues with killing sentinels at the moment. I mean, they do me a little tiny bit of damage when I fight them. Some more tech. It's pretty much all I want from them. But yeah, so that's pretty much No Man's Sky. It's us walking around, finding things. Let's, oh. Should really get some more plutonium. But yeah, so once we're done in a system, we can go to another system, as long as we've got enough warp fuel, which is the most costly of the materials. And then we can just... Oh. That's the next place I want to go. I'm just going to make sure that there's nothing here. It wants me to upload some of the... so I can call this... it's basically strawberry, isn't it? So every time I upload that stuff... Oh, shit! Need to upload this stuff as well. Oh god, there's loads of stuff that needs to be done. I can name the systems. Happy fun system. Oh shit, son! Every plat. So every system's worth 5,000, and every planet's worth 2,000. So. That's good remembering, and every waypoint is 1,000 when you upload them. I will upload them at some point, but you know, that'll be time consuming. I'm pretty lazy. Resource deposit detected. That sounds nice. Slightly above it. Should get there a bit faster. Don't know what I was doing over here. Apparently it's quite chilly on this planet. I don't mind. Because, hello. What are you? What happened to your hands? As you get older, your hands get weirder. Do you want anything? That's right. Carbon. Oh my god. Don't know what you were. No, don't you run. No. You're good. Oh, zinc. Zinc is useful. It's okay. God damn it. It's okay. Yeah, he's a good, weird thing. What are you even? Don't know what that is. At least there's a reasonable amount of life on this planet, which is useful. Don't know what it's useful for. It's kind of looking derpy, really. So a cog over there. I think he's found some loot for me. I'm sure it's great. It's probably he's just pooed. He's gone, look, Master, I pooed. Good job. And let's go to this manufacturing facility. It might be an all-out brawl with Sentinels, which would be good, because I like killing Sentinels. And I'm happy to do anything that's anti-Atlas as well, because literally, screw the Atlas. Unless he's, I don't know, he gives me free stuff. Cool. Right. Let's kill this one. Reload. While we find the other one. Done. One behind. Try and get him before he alerts the others. You're going down, mate. It's much easier on the... God damn it. It could have been... This is my little pet! He's helping me! He loves me! Oh. Trino module... Any tech? Some new tech? Cool. Haven't actually seen Nicol yet. Oh, sorry. Just like that, he was dead. Oh, got that. Bloody self-replicating robots. Robots I hate the most. There we go. Anything that needs recharging the exosuit? I can't believe I used sync for that. That's probably quite derpy of me. Multi-tool. Let's use that. Let's use that. Nice. Let's grab all this. I love the fact that it's just loads of tech that drops in the room. Why wouldn't you kill all of them that you meet? What have you found? Do you want some of this? Want some more food? What's this? What have you found for me? What's that? Just literally find treasure. I'm a troublemaker. Good job. He's the best. dropping that. What's this going to be? I don't know what that is. Thank you. Weird, big-headed alien thing that loves me. What's going on here? Manufacturing facility. Cut the camera feed. Said visual. Oh, we couldn't make suspension fluid before. That was the thing that was stopping me from creating warp cells, which would allow me to travel. Oh my god. Well, that's awesome. Because now we can travel really far. I'm going to save. And then we're going to look at whatever the hell that is. That jumping pineapple acorn. Because, you know... What are you? And why are you so happy? Shh. Oh my god, there's more of them. What the fuck are you? Are you a... You want Heridium. You make the sound of a triple. You are getting fed Heridium. Look how happy you are! Whatever you are, I can't tell. What is going on here? I think you're my favourite. You weird flower blobs. You literally are my favourites. There's a source of Heridium up there, which is what they apparently eat. And I just need a load of carbon to make warp cells, basically, I think. Let's work it out. Change from mining beam. So now we can create... Press E, I can create... only 50 carbon a time. So that is... It's a big tree. Let's cut this tree down. So now you should be able to create two of those bad boys. Stop pressing left mouse. So now we can convert that into plutonium. So plutonium are the red crystals. So this. So normally they're shown as a lightning beam. Lightning beam, lightning bolt. There we go. No. So, playing this for a little bit has made me realise that it's quite enjoyable, but it's not something I'm going to play for very long at all. I mean, I'll probably try and complete all the routes in the game while exploring, while chilling out. But I mean, it hasn't grabbed me massively. I'll probably still just play Overwatch and Star Citizen. I will do some gameplay, but it'll be of Star Citizen, I think. I really like that. It just appeals to me. I know it's really buggy in alpha. But I just enjoy it, and it just works better in my head. But I mean, No Man's Sky, it's fine, it's casual, it's chill, and we'll probably get a much better experience in the future once they patch some bits and bobs, and they make some of the slowdown. I mean, it's gone down to 14 frames, and now back up to 100, and now 40. It's just crazy frame wise. There's a few little problems with it, but I mean, it's certainly enjoyable. It's just overly hyped. But yeah, if you've done some research and you know it's just the end game of Spore, basically, and that it's a casual discovery game, you're gonna have fun. But for me, I'm not gonna have it as a big thing on my channel at all. I might occasionally do another video on it if I can find out something else, but maybe not. Who knows? You scaring the hell out of you. But yeah, don't forget to like and subscribe, guys. Please check out my channel for more Star Citizen rather than No Man's Sky. Although it wasn't an unenjoyable experience, it just... I don't know. It's made me realise how much I like some other games, and this is cool, but... Doesn't grab me. Hey, bro. Don't know what happened to his face. You've Valkyrie still? She's still a Valkyrie. Looks totally different from the other Valkyrie, obviously. Interloper weapon, honorable Valkyrie, replace. Yeah. Okay. Oh, thank you. Oh, it's got laser slots. Appreciate it. Thank you very much. Let's compare with the current one. Can I transfer stuff over? Let's take the item. Oh, wow. That's pretty cool. It looks pretty cool. Thank you. Let's interact with this. We know a load of Valkyrie words now. So bottom left here, there is some numbers. It's a number sequence, which keeps on pushing up by one. So the next one will be 4463. And that will give us the location of a new world. Thank you very much. Oh, God. Oh, and it's a big alien monolith thing, which we want to go to in a bit. But yeah, as I said, guys, please don't forget to like and subscribe. This has been No Man's Sky. I might go into it saying that. I might play it for a little bit longer and go, ooh, it's got much more depth than I thought. So that's a certain possibility. I am quite flaky. And let's save it. Save it before we go. Because that would be bad if we didn't. It'd be very bad. You take care, guys, and I'll see you next time.